Hello everybody, are you having trouble launching Black Ops 6 on Xbox Battle Pass? Well, in this video, I've compiled every single solution to every single problem people are having, and a couple of solutions that I haven't included in previous videos, so watch the video if you're having this issue. So the first thing you want to do is repair or reset the game. So in order to do that, go to search, type in settings, left click this. Here, you go to apps, go to installed apps, search for Call of Duty. I have it at the top here. Click on the three dots here, go to advanced options, go to repair, and then reset. And this fixes the issue for many people. The next thing you want to do is exclude it from Windows antivirus. So go to Windows security. Well, type in Windows security. Under virus or threat protection, go down. Click on add or remove exclusions. And you want to add an exclusion. I have it right here. But what you want to do is say add an exclusion. Click on folder. This will come up. In order to find this, go to your Xbox app, right click on Call of Duty, click on manage, go to files, go to browse, and here you will see Call of Duty in the games you have installed. Left click on that, copy and paste this file path. So add an exclusion, folder, here. I have it copy and pasted already, but paste it and this will come up and you select content and that is it. It is now added as an exclusion to Windows security. Alternatively, you can simply turn off threat protection. I of course don't recommend this, but if you want to get the game running, this is the easiest way to do it. So the next solution is to put Xbox Game Pass and Black Ops 6 on the same drive. They need to be on the same partition for some reason. If Xbox Game Pass is on the C partition and Black Ops 6 is on the D partition, the game will crash on startup. I do not know why, it is very odd, but that is the case. So you want to ensure that they are installed on the same partition. If it is not, you can uninstall Call of Duty by right-click on it and reinstall it onto the correct partition. If you want to change the partition in which Xbox Game Pass is installed, what you're going to have to do is click on search, go to settings. Here, click on storage, scroll down, and go to advanced storage settings. And click on where new content is saved. And here you want to change this to whatever drive you want Xbox Game Pass to install to. I only have the C partition here because I only have one drive, but many people will have a D or more than one drive. Okay, after you've done that and that still hasn't worked, what you're gonna wanna do is run Call of Duty as an administrator. So in order to do that, open Xbox Game Pass, right click on Call of Duty, go to manage, go to files, go to browse, go to Call of Duty, go to content, scroll down until you see COD.exe. By default, you will not see .exe, you will not see the endings of the files unless you have them enabled. You will just see the file name COD. That is completely fine. Right click on this, go into properties, go into compatibility, and click on run this program as an administrator. You can also try run this program in compatibility mode for Windows 7. This does occasionally fix the issue for some people. You can also try to disable full screen optimizations. This is an issue many people seem to have. Now, some people don't have the compatibility mode. What you can do is also right click on it and hit run as administrator. Although this is kind of annoying to have to do every single time, this is an option. And this will solve an issue for many, many people. Now, if you've done this and it still isn't working, here's another option. I do not recommend this if you don't want to mess with your registry, but I will put the link to this registry editor path into the video description. But go into search, type in registry editor. Here, this will come up, and you want to copy and paste this from the video description into here. And this will come up, and here you'll see this file called image path. This is a randgrid.sys. This is causing a lot of problems for a lot of different people. What you want to do is delete it. Yes. Now what this will do, if you try to run it right now, this game, Call of Duty, will come up, will crash. So it will come up with error 0x0xFFFF or something like that. Yeah, here we go. That is fine. So when this happens, you go into, again, settings. You go into apps, installed apps, Call of Duty, here, advanced options. We've done this before, but you want to repair this and reset this. And once you've done that, reboot Call of Duty. And this time, Call of Duty will run properly. So by deleting this registry and repairing the game, this will solve an issue. I think it's a 0x9 error that a lot of people are having. But this is definitely something that you want to try anyway. Okay, so this is launching fine. Let me get out of it. Okay, so after you've done that, what you want to do is try to reinstall the base game. So you want to right click on Call of Duty, hit uninstall. Uninstall the game. When you reinstall the game, it will ask you if you want to install Call of Duty plus zombies plus multiplayer plus a bunch of different add-ons. What you want to do is install only the base game and then run it to see if it runs smoothly. And then if it does run smoothly, add on other parts one by one. This seems to fix a lot of problems for a lot of different people. If you've done all of these steps and it still isn't working, what you can do is right click on Call of Duty, go to files, hit verify and repair, and see if this repairs any kind of corruption you might have. And if you've done all of these steps, what you can do, again, I put these links onto the video description below, but you can verify the game files. So this is a PowerShell command. So take this, go to search, type in PowerShell, right click on PowerShell, hit run as administrator, paste this into PowerShell, then paste the next one into PowerShell. What this does is this downloads a package from Microsoft Gaming Services, and this installs it into Xbox Game Pass, and this allows you to fix the games that you have installed. So after you've done this, you need to restart the Game Pass here. Let me do it. And after you restart it, what you will see is you'll have a verify and repair option that wasn't there before. In order to access it, you left click on your profile, you go into support, and here you will see Gaming Services Repair Tool. This will repair every single game that you have installed. So you left click on that. Then it takes a couple of minutes to run. After you've done that, restart the game and see if this works. Now, next is my final fix, but this is the one that seems to work for the most people. So what you want to do is download a batch file. I'm sorry, a bat file. I will put the download links into the video description. Now, this will be flagged on Windows as a virus, or I should say it will be flagged as untrustworthy executable. You're gonna have to trust me, but I'm gonna upload the TXT file as well. If you're unsure about that, what you can do is download the TXT file, look at the contents. You can look at them, it's not that complicated. And if it looks okay to you, change the executable to a BAT file and then run it, and it will run fine. So if you're in Windows 10, you want to download this file. If you're in Windows 11, download this file. Once you've downloaded this file, right click on it, hit run as administrator. This will come up, say run anyway. Again, it's not a virus. You gotta trust me on that. It will come up with enter file location here. So what you do is go to your Xbox Game Pass, right click on Call of Duty, click on manage, click on files, click on browse, go to Call of Duty, go to content, and copy and paste this file path. You paste that here, you enter, and that is it. You reboot Xbox Game Pass, and that should have fixed your problem. So these are every single solution I am currently aware of. I will do my best to check the comments, and I will do my best to answer every single question you have. So if any of these worked for you, please leave a comment and telling other people what worked for you, so we can all play this game together. And if none of these worked for you, please leave a comment and I will do my best to get back to you.